We're John and Suzanne Kilner, and we both grew up here on the North Shore. We went to Sunday school, we went to church, but we really had no sense of meaning. It wasn't until college that God brought us together with people who shared with us the fact that it's possible to actually know God personally. And so that really changed the way we view life. We knew that God had created us and had a purpose for us. So Suzanne went on to master's degree studies at Yale, and I went on to do master's degree at Gordon-Conwell Theological Seminary, and then a master's and PhD at Harvard University. And we ended up back here on the North Shore in 1991. It wasn't until 2012 that Suzanne and I actually became connected with Harvest. What a tremendous gift of God the fellowship has been to us. In August of 2017, that's when the bombshell dropped. I had my physical exam, normal annual physical exam, and there was one number in my blood that was a little off. And what they discovered was the very rare blood cancer that causes the blood to thicken. And the number was through the roof.
We were both in shock because he was otherwise very healthy and very strong. I tried very hard to get my heart to a place where I was willing, if God wanted to take him, for him to die. And I couldn't bring myself to that point and struggled with it a great deal.
What they explained was that it is an incurable cancer, but they've developed basically two approaches that can slow it down, starting with approach number one, which involved a chemotherapy, it involved a high-dose steroid, and it involved an infusion of monoclonal antibodies. When they did the first infusion, I started shivering, and then I started shaking, and then all of a sudden my blood pressure just started falling through the floor, and I was just rapidly heading into unconsciousness, and they had to call a code blue. Now, if you've watched TV, you know, you've seen these situations that the patient is on a gurney and they're racing down the hallway and there's like eight healthcare professionals gathered around. Well, that is exactly what it's like. It was a horrendous experience. It just, you know, shook me to the core. I was just like crying out in my mind and my heart and my soul to God to sustain me, and just experiencing, knowing that God was there with me. I just can't tell you what an amazing experience that was. So in October, we started the only other major avenue available. And what that constitutes is a $500 pill that I have to take every day. So yes, that's been an expensive situation, but you know what? God has provided miraculously. And the impact was amazing. I mean, by December of 2018, just a couple of months later, the IgM numbers absolutely plummeted. And in December of 2020, they went down so much that they were approaching the level of normal range for IgM, which is just absolutely amazing.
One of my life verses that has helped me through many things is from 2 Corinthians. My grace is sufficient in you, for my power is made perfect in your weakness.
My whole life has been trying to be strong, trying to be good, trying to achieve, and I need strength and ability in order to do that. And here's this undermining and sapping my strength. But what the Apostle Paul learned was God demonstrates his strength precisely through our weakness. When I turn to God for the strength that I need, that's when I experience the power and, more importantly, the presence of God to be able to get through what is before me.
I now live our life assuming that John will live for, I hope, a long time, and that I can trust God that when the time comes for him to go to heaven, that then at that point God will give me grace to endure it. And I know that this kind of faith is a gift from God, and I am very grateful to have been given that gift.
I've come to the point where I can thank God. I can thank God for all that I've been through. These last several years have been the richest time in my life in terms of personal experience of the goodness of God. And yes, it's been hard. Yes, it's been difficult. Yes, it's been challenging. But what could be better than to know Christ and for Christ to live his life in a way that's manifested to the world through you? Life doesn't get any better than that.